الحمد لله المتفرد باسمه الأسماء والمختص بالملك الأعز الأحماء الذي ليس من دونه منتهى ولا وراءه مرمام، الظاهر لا تخيلا ووهما، الباطن تقدسا لا عدما، وسع كل شيء رحمة وعلما، وأسبغ على أوليائه نعما عما، وبعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم أنفسهم عربا وعجما، وأزكاهم محتدا ومنما، وأشدهم بهم رأفة ورحما، حاشاه ربه عيبا ووصما، وزكاه روحا وجسما، وآتاه حكمة وحكما، فآمن به وصدف عنه من كتب الله عليه الشقاء حتما، ومن كان في هذه أعمى فهو في الآخرة أعمى، صلى الله عليه صلاة تنمو وتنمى، وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة المسلمون، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، معاشر الصالحين، كلمة المنبر في هذا الشهر الأغر، شهر ربيع الأزهر، سيكون حديثها المتواضع إشادة وذكرى ومدحا للذي هز العالم وأيقظ التاريخ وأذهل الزمان ودان له العظماء. الكلام اليوم عن الذي بذل المعروف وأطعم الجائع وأكرم الضيف وحمل الكل وأغاث الملهوف. الكلام اليوم الذي فاض قلبه رقة ورحمة، فكان أرحم بالناس من آبائهم وأمهاتهم، واستحق أن يشيد به رب العالمين بقوله بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. الكلام اليوم عباد الله عن الذي أخرج الإنسانية من عبادة العباد والأوثان إلى عبادة رب العباد والأكوان. فالسلام عليك يا محمد، السلام عليك يا رسول الله، السلام عليك يا معلم الدنيا السلام، السلام عليك يا جميل الظاهر، يا ذكي الباطن، يا عظيم الأخلاق، يا رائع الآداب، يا جميل الصفات، ويا عذب الشمائل. السلام عليك أيها النبي، فقد سلمت عليك الأشجار والأحجار، وتحدثت إليك الظباء والجمال والحمائم، وسبح الطعام في فمك، وسبح الحصى في كفك، وتفجر الماء من بين أصابعك، واهتز لك الجبل، وحن إليك الجذع، وظل لك الغمام، وانشق لك القمر، ونصرتك الملائكة، ولطفك جبريل، واحتفت بك السماوات، وبلغت سدرة المنتهى، وصلى خلفك النبيون. فسبحان من كملك، وسبحان من جملك، فسبحان من أدبك، وسبحان من أعطاك. فالسلام عليك يا حبيبنا وقرة أعيننا، طبت حيا وميتا، صلى الله عليه صلاة تنمو وتنمى، وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, today we will talk about a unique journey, the life journey of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is full of countless examples, a life that shows his status as a role model for Muslims and non-Muslims, societies and individuals, a life journey, ibadallah, that is dominated by superior morality, good habits, noble, gentle feelings, and superior skills. In other words, it is a journey in which humanity can find true lessons, whether for the rich or the prosperous, the poor or the needy, the ruler or the ruled, the teacher or the student, the preacher or the counselor, the employer or the employee. It is a life, ibadallah, that softens the hearts, brings tears to the eyes, increases faith, love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah described him in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And we have sent you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not but as a mercy for the alameen, mankind, jinns, and all that exists. Ibadallah. Many questions have been made by Muslims and non-Muslims regarding what our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given to the humanity and to the world. Within the sequence of this khutbah, inshallah, we will try to shed the light on the most crucial acts or events that illustrate the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the purpose of his message, what he has given to the humanity, and some of his attributes sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah described him in the Quran saying, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily we have sent you as a witness and the bearer of a glad tidings and the warner, and as one who invite to Allah by his leave, and as a lamp spreading light. It should be known, ibadallah, that we have developed a problem of turning to other sources for solutions, while we have the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the example of the best of creation right beneath our eyes, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the sealed of all the prophets. Living in the dark of the darkness, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam transferred humanity from the obedience and the submission to men and idols into the worship and the submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And this is the greatest honor for humanity. This was clearly illustrated when Ja'far ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu stood up and addressed the king of Abyssinia and Najashi in the following words. أَيُّهَا الْمَلِكُ أَيُّهَا الْمَلِكُ كُنَّا قَوْمًا أَهْلَ جَاهِلِيَّةِ نَعْبُدُ الْأَصْنَامِ وَنَأْكُلُ الْمَيْتَةِ وَنَأْتِي الْفَوَاحِشِ وَيَأْكُلُ الْقَوِيُّ مِنَّا الضَّعِيفِ فَكُنَّا عَلَى ذَلِكَ حتى بعث الله إلينا رسولا منا نعرف نسبه وصدقه وأمانته وعفافه فدعانا إلى الله لنوحده ونعبده ونخلع ما كنا نعبد نحن وآباؤنا من دونه من الحجارة والأوثان. O King, we were plunged into the depth of ignorance and barbarism. We adored idols. We lived in unchastity, we ate the dead bodies, we knew no law but that of the strong. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised among us a man of whose birth, truthfulness, honesty and purity, he called to the oneness of Allah. He forbid us the worship of idols, and we have allowed what he has allowed and prohibited what he has prohibited. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam led the foundation for tolerance when it comes to the choice of faith. Allah says in the Quran, لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي. There shall be no compulsion in acceptance of religion. The right course has become clear from the wrong. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also clarified the right of non-Muslims and guaranteed protections of their lives, children, property and honor. He treated them with kindness and rational dialogue. He was able to win their hearts with that ibadallah. So many of them accepted Islam. Allah described him in the Quran saying, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. And by the mercy of Allah, you dealt with them gently, and had you been severe and harsh-hearted, they would have broken away from about you. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a mercy sent by Allah to all creatures. In fact, his teachings include mercy even to birds and animals, and forbid harming them without right or reason. فعن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رأى حمرة وهي طير صغير تفرش لما أخذ بعض الصحابة ولدها، فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من فزعها أو من فزع هذه بولدها ردوا ولدها إليها. ورأى قرية نمل قد حرقناها، فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم من فعل هذا؟ قلنا نحن. قال إنه لا ينبغي أن يعذب بالنار إلا رب النار. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه narrated, we were in a journey with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. We saw a bird with her two young ones, which we later captured. The bird came and began to spread its wings. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and said, who grieved this for its young ones? Return its young ones to it. He also sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw an ant village that we had burnt. He asked, who has burned this? We replied, we did. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it is not proper to punish with fire except the Lord of the fire. Ibadallah, if that the case with animals, what will be the question for those people who are slaughtering and killing and harming people every single day? What will be their answer when they will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah says in the Quran, وَقِفُوهُمْ إِنَّهُمْ مَسْئُولُونَ. Stop them. Indeed, they will be asked. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed unparalleled respect, appreciation for all the prophets who precede him. Among them, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, and Jesus, peace be upon to them all. ففي صحيح مسلم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن مثلي ومثل الأنبياء من قبلي كمثل رجل بنى بيتا فأحسنه وأجمله إلا موضع لبنة فجعل الناس يطوفون أي بذلك البيت ويعجبون له ويقولون هلا وضعت هذه اللبنة؟ فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم فأنا اللبنة وأنا خاتم النبيين. In Sahih Muslim, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu reported, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the similitude, the likeness of mine and that of the apostles, the prophets before me, is that of a person who built a house quite imposing and beautiful, but for one brick in one of its corners, people would go around it, appreciating the building, but saying, why has the brick not been fixed here? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am that brick, and I am the last of the apostles. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam defended human rights for both males and females, for young and old, regardless of their social status. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam established a set of sublime principles One example being in the speech he gave during his farewell pilgrimage, in which he declared, no transgression against people's life, property, and honor. Not to forget his statement, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he said, treat your women well and be kind to them, for they are your partners and committed helpers. These principles, ibadallah, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam laid down long before the world knew of the Magna Carta in 1215 in England, or the Worldwide Declaration of Human Rights in 1948. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam elevated the importance of morality in human life. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always putting into practice what he preached. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma kama hassanta khalqi fa hassin khuluqi. O Allah, you have made my creation perfect, so make my moral characteristic also be the best. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited people to use their mind, to discover the universe around them and to acquire knowledge. He confirmed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards such deeds at a time when scientists and intellectuals in other civilizations were suffering persecution and accusation. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, من سلك طريقا يبتغي فيه علما سهل الله له طريقا إلى الجنة. He who follows a path in quest of knowledge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the path of Jannah easy to him. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam presented to the world a perfect model of brotherhood among human beings. In his farewell speech, he stated that all mankind is from Adam and Eve. An Arab has no superiority over non-Arab. An Arab has no superiority over an Arab. A black has no superiority over a white, nor a white has a superiority over a black, except by piety and good action. This was clearly symbolized, ibadallah, in his treatment to his companions, may Allah be pleased with them. They were given equal opportunities to belong to and serve their religion. Among them, ibadallah, were Suhaib, a Byzantine, Bilal, an Abyssinian, Salman, a Persian, and many other non-Arabs. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has done or offered to the humanity is much more, and it can't be mentioned in this brief outline or this khutbah. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله المستحق لغاية التحميد، المتوحد في كبريائه المانع، فلا معطي لما منع ولا راد لما يريد. خلق الخلائق وسلكهم أحسن الطريق إلى الأمر الرشيد. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله المقرب والحبيب، خلقه نعمة ومبعثه رحمة، من سلم عليه رد عليه السلام. أضاء الدنيا بسنته وأنقذ الأمة بشفاعته، صلى الله عليه صلاة تنمو وتنمى، وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله, I would like to end my talk with one of the most eloquent and deeply moving descriptions of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In fact, knowing him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam increases our love, nourishes our faith, and elevates our status in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ففي صحيح البخاري عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال فوالذي نفسي بيده لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده. It was narrated by Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, by him in whose hands my life is, none of you will have faith till he loves me more than his father and his children. The question to be asked, ibadallah, how can we love him if we don't know him? My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, for some Muslims, this may be the first time to hear the description of their Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and how he looked like. Ummu Mi'bad, may Allah be pleased with her, a Badwin woman, gave this ummah an astonishing description of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا ظَاهِرَ الْوَضَاءَةِ, I saw a man of a striking appearance, أَبْلَجَ الْوَجْهِ, radiant face, حَسَنَ الْخَلْقِ, beautifully created, لَمْ تَعِبْهُ الثَّجْلَةِ, his belly was not protruding, وَلَمْ تُزْرِ بِهِ السَّعْلَةِ, nor was his head disproportionate and small, وَسِيمٌ قَسِيمٌ, proportionate and delicate, finally made a specimen of a creation, فِي عَيْنَيْهِ دَعَجٌ, in his eyes there was a contrast. The dark was immensely dark, and the white was excessively white. وَفِي أَشْفَارِهِ وَطْفٌ, His eyelashes were long. وَفِي صَوْتِهِ صَهَلٌ, in his voice a natural echo. وَفِي عُنُقِهِ سَطَعٌ, and his neck was elegantly long. وَفِي لِحْيَتِهِ كَثَافَةٌ, and his beard was full and thick. أَزَجْ أَقْرًا, and his eyebrows were arched, but no joint, it was separated. إِنْ صَمَتَ فَعَلَيْهِ الْوَقَارِ, when he was silent, dignity covered him. وَإِنْ تَكَلَّمَا سَمَاهُ وَعَلَاهُ الْبَهَاءِ, and when he spoke, it was audible and clear, almost commanding and overtaking. أَجْمَلَ النَّاسِ وَأَبْهَاهُمْ مِنْ بَعِيدٍ, from afar, the most striking and outstanding in appearance. وَأَحْسَنُهُمْ وَأَجْمَلُهُمْ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ, and when he came near, the best of them and the most handsome of them in closeness. حُلْوُ الْمَنْطِقِ, he has such an exalted and sweet level of logic, like when he used to speak, it was so coherently logical. It was smooth and easy to understand. فَصْلٌ لَا نَزْرٌ وَلَا هَزْرٌ, he was to the point, not excessive, not too short. كَأَنَّ مَنْطِقَهُ خَرَزَاتُ نَظْمٍ يَتَحَذَّرٌ, his logic, his utterances, his words were like a jewels coming out of a necklace, calculated, polished, one after another. It was flow magically. رَبْعَةٌ, he was medium in height. Your eye did not have to strain to look up at him, nor was it tedious to look down at him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a comfortable sight to look at. لَهُ رُفَقَاءُ يَحُفُّونَ بِهِ, he had friends, they were trying to serve and protect him. إِنْ قَالَ سَمِعُوا لِقَوْلِهِ, when he used to say something, they used to hearken or to listen to what he used to say. وَإِنْ أَمَرَ تَبَادَرُوا لِأَمْرِهِ, and when he commanded, they used to compete to fulfill his command. Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه قال, رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في ليلة مقمرة, فجعلت أنظر إلى القمر, ثم قال, وأنظر إلى النبي, وأنظر إلى القمر, وأنظر إلى النبي, وأنظر إلى القمر, وأنظر إلى النبي, ثم قال رضي الله عنه, فوالله لقد كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في عيني أحسن من القمر. Anas ibn Malik says, I came one night, it was a full night moon, and he said, I looked at the moon and it was beautiful and handsome. Then he said, let me go see if the moon is more handsome and beautiful, or my Prophet is more handsome and beautiful. So I went and I saw him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, standing afar. So I looked at his face and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon. And he said, Wallahi, he was more handsome than the moon in its entirety. Muslims, this is Muhammad, Rasulullah. This is just the look of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibadallah, many Muslims claim that they follow and love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this claim requires a proof, and the proof can only justified or can only be justified by action. And the action, ibadallah, can only be derived from the book of Allah and the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the condition of this love in the Quran saying, قُلْ إِن كُنتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say, O Muhammad, to mankind, if you really love Allah, then follow me. Accept Islam, follow the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah will love you and forgive your sins. And Allah is all forgiven, most merciful. My dear Muslim brothers and sisters in Islam, let me conclude with this profound hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that identifies who we are as Muslims and where we stand as one ummah. When it comes to apply the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rawa al-Bukhari wa Muslim anna an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala مثل المؤمنين في توادهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم كمثل الجسد الواحد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. Reported by Al-Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the believers in their mutual kindness, compassion and sympathy are just like one body. When one of the limbs suffers, the whole body responds to it with wakefulness and fever. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us into the right path. Ameen. Allahumma ja'al jam'ana hadha jam'an marhuma wa tafarruqana min ba'dihi tafarruqan saliman min ash-sharri ma'suma wa la taj'alillahumma fina wa la ma'ana wa la minna shaqiyya wa la mahruma. Allahumma la taj'al lana fi makanina hadha dhanban illa ghafartah wa la hamman illa farrajtah wa la karban illa nafastah wa la maridan illa shafaytah wa la aduwan illa khadaltah ولا مدينا إلا قضيت دينه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنك ترى مكاننا, اللهم إنك ترى مكاننا وتسمع كلامنا ولا يخفى عنك شيء من أمرنا. نحن البؤساء الفقراء المساكين, نسألك اللهم مسألة المسكين ونبتهل إليك ابتهال الخاضع الذليل. نسألك أن تغفر لنا الذنوب وتستر منا العيوب. اللهم يا غفار الذنوب اغفر ذنوبنا, ويا ستار العيوب استر عيوبنا. اللهم لا تجعل لنا في مكاننا هذا ولا اللهم لا تجعل لنا في مكاننا هذا ذنبا الا غفرته. اللهم هؤلاء عبادك جاءوك من كل مكان يرجون رحمتك. اللهم زدهم ولا تنقصهم, واكرمهم ولا تهنهم, واعطهم ولا تحرمهم وارضهم وارض عنهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.